Welcome back once again, everyone. My name is Prestige. This is episode number 44 of a series that I like to call Elite Weapons of Advanced Warfare. In this series, we take a look at elite variations of weapons you'll earn in your supply drops while playing through Call of Duty Advanced Warfare. I let you know whether or not those weapons are worth keeping or scrapping for the 2000 XP. If you happen to miss any of the other 43 episodes, I'll make sure to have a complete playlist linked down below in the description and in the form of a card, which you can find on your screen right now. But without further ado, let us get into today's episode, which is the one, the only, the SAC-3 Introvert. This is a single-handed SAC-3. You're able to aim down sight. It has a built-in red dot sight. And honestly, I'm not too big of a fan of that. I think that there should be other room for other attachments if you didn't want to use a red dot sight. But who knows? We'll talk a little bit more about that later. Let's go ahead and move right into the bad. First thing you're going to notice is there is an accuracy decrease. Now, what this is going to do is it's going to add a little bit more view kick. It's going to make it a little bit more difficult to control. And one of the worst parts about this variant is you cannot get a foregrip, which is unfortunate. I wish that your character would just take his other hand and hold the base where the magazine is and kind of hold it a little bit more so it doesn't have that much recoil, if you catch my drift. I don't understand the whole one-handed thing. I think it looks a little bit cool, but I really wish he would use his other hand and hold that recoil pattern and make sure you have it a little bit more centered on wherever you're shooting. It would help everybody in the long run. Next up for the good, you're going to find that there is a fire rate increase, and this is obviously going to increase your overall rate of fire. One of the very cool things with this weapon is you can actually put on a rapid fire attachment. However, I would not suggest it because of that built-in red dot sight. You're going to have a lack of attachments that you're able to use. So let's go ahead and cover that really quick. If you end up getting this weapon, which I will say this right now, it's actually very good. That built-in fire rate increase is going to be pretty comparable to the MP11. It has a similar increase and decrease to stats based on the MP11 squeaker. However, the squeaker is going to have a lot more recoil control because you can put on a foregrip. And we'll talk all about that weapon when that episode comes through. I still need to cover that weapon overall. But moving back over to the Introvert, there's only a select few attachments that I can recommend for this specific variant because of that fire rate increase. I would say go with the extended magazines and the advanced rifling. That's what I'm using in this particular gameplay. Otherwise, the rest of the attachments just seem pretty dull and not really good or beneficial to you. Yes, you could use a parabolic microphone to your advantage, but how much are you going to be staring at the minimap? You're going to be more focused on what's happening in front of your face. Same thing can be said with a tracker. If you hit somebody with this weapon, one bullet's going to mark them and they'll be on the minimap and that's that. But it's just one of those things where you're paying more attention to what's happening directly in front of you rather than what's happening on your minimap. Now, for a submachine gun, this is missing a lot of crucial attachments, one of which being the laser sight. You can get them on the dual wield variant, but you can't get them on the singular variant, which is very unfortunate. And I totally feel that a laser sight would be beneficial for this particular variant because of that increased rate of fire. If I had it my way, this thing would also have a foregrip. I think that with all of the other submachine guns having foregrips, it would only be fair to make one for this particular weapon, or like I was saying before, take your left hand and put it on the weapon. Hold that thing steady while you're firing. This is pretty much just a vector if you think about it. Like I was saying before, there's a lot of different submachine guns that you can use, a lot of different elite variants. This one is pretty good if you want to have a challenge for yourself, but if you want to take the easy way out, there's so many other submachine guns out there that will do more damage, that will have a faster rate of fire, that will have less recoil, that you're able to use more effectively. This one is just there. It's good for show. It's good to say, hey, I have it, I guess you would say. But if you're somebody that's not ever going to use this particular variant, I would say go ahead and scrap it, get your 2000 XP. Otherwise, keep it in your inventory, keep it in your armory. Make sure that you have that if you wanted to kind of show it off or use something out of the ordinary, because to me, this is a pretty rare weapon. You don't see it too often in the multiplayer. You don't see people run the SAC-3 too often anyway in the multiplayer. So if I see this, that's kind of like a wow moment, you know? Somebody's using something different. Somebody's using something out of the ordinary. So for me personally, I'm gonna keep it in my armory. I'm going to use it as one of those wow moments when I want to use something out of the ordinary or do something different or do something unique. And I think that you guys should try it out as well. Keep it in your inventory, or if you're not going to use the SAC-3, go ahead and scrap it for the 2000 XP. But I hope you all enjoyed this episode of Elite Weapons of Advanced Warfare. It was recorded in 1080p, 60 FPS quality with my Elgato Game Capture HD60. If you would like to learn more, I'll put a link down below in the description to the Elgato Gaming website where you can find more about the capture card that I use to record such high quality videos right here on YouTube. But if you enjoyed this particular video, make sure to click the thumbs up button down below and do not forget to subscribe for more awesome videos each and every day. Until next time, everybody, I am out. Peace.